Hi, I'm going to do a quick review of how to rearrange colors and combine colors with within DesignShop version 10. I have this design here, and it's just the one day.ofm that comes with the machine, and I added just some text at the bottom. So as you can see over my project view here, I have 5 unique color changes. Yet I can see on the left-hand side of the screen, I only have 4 unique thread colors being used in this design. So to rearrange my colors, let's say I want to sew the word name at the same time that I do the pairs, which happens to be color number 1. All I have to do is select the item I want to move, so in this case, color 5, left-click, and drag it. And you see the black line that appears? That's where, when I let go of my left click, where it's going to drop it. So now I've got my color 1, which is my pairs, my color 2, which is the name. Now to combine the colors, I can use the little arrow right here, and that will merge color 2 up into color 1. So click there, you can see it tossed color 2 up into number 1. I can also do that same activity by selecting what I want to combine. So I can click on color 1, hold the control key down, select on color 2, and again combine the colors. I can also, and just undid that so you can see yet another way, these are back to back and they're the exact same color. So if I want, I can just turn on this auto merge colors. And the minute you click that, it will happen, and there's not really any undoing of it. So I'd have to go change it. So here, auto merge color blocks, and now because they were stacked on top of each other, they auto merge together. So if I want to turn that off, I just unclick it. So as you're rearranging colors, just be careful that you're paying attention to how the design was intended to be sewn. So I moved the word name up, but let's say instead I moved the leaves down, or the pairs down. To the word name. So what you'll see is I just destroyed this design because it was intended to be sewn in a different order. The pairs have these running stitches that are going from spot to spot to minimize having to do trims. And it's designed that way because you're going to end up covering it up with the next stitching. So as you're rearranging colors, just take care to double check and make sure you're not actually changing the intent of how the design is supposed to be sewn. So I'm going to move that back up to color 1. All right, and that's that.